Za uwe fluik ni maya nifta banting nikunting nari tumpaya katos ake akatos e kontalana weruta yasi za uwe fluik ni maya nifta banting nikunting nari.
Well met, my dears.
Well met indeed.
What brings you here?
Your counsel I need.
Yaga the bony, Yaga the great.
You want to manipulate?
The Tsar's fate. Upon his throne, I will bestow a fate of sorrow, bad luck, and woe. The rightful Tsar had failed my test. He was unkind, just like the rest. He said to me, "Leave, ugly hag," when all I did was ask for bread. And as his guards drove me away, I laid my curse, and he heard me say, "Oh, I shall leave, but hear this from me. How you'll treat others, treated you'll be. The one who is cursed with dreadful luck will be around when your throne turns to muck. But if you kill him by your own command, all of your tsardom will turn into sand."
Yaga, our friend, we lend you our skill.
Ivan, we shall use.
To fulfill your will.
Blacksmith?
You work in the village, and people say you are followed by bad luck. Broken swords, bent nails, splintered helmets, crumbled wheels. Everything you create shatters to dust, and you bring misfortune upon us all.
One day, I was at home with my Baba, and she said to me,
"Oh, Ivan, my needles broke again. Would you make your poor old grandma some new ones?"
"Sure, Baba. I'll make you a couple so strong you'll be able to weave chains with them. I just need to find some enchanted iron."
"Be careful, Ivan."
"Do not worry. If there's misfortune in the world, I haven't met it yet."
"Oh, and if you're out there, see if you can find yourself a wife."
Later that day, I was going through a beautiful forest. Little did I know what would follow. My way was blocked. I had to smash through using my hammer. I had to go through some thorny spikes. I quickly rolled through them. Wild animals were upon me. I got ready for the fight. Tired from the fight, I approached a clearing. Bad fate was waiting for me there.
"Dear traveler, with that sweet face, what brings you here to Lico's place?"
"I left my grandma at the door to go and find some magic ore."
"You seek magic? Are you stuck? How do you feel about your luck?"
"Bad luck? I think that's just in tales. Hard work and patience never fails."
"A non-believer then. I see. Looks like, come now with me before you're thinner. You're just in time to be my dinner."
"Your dinner?"
"I have to eat now. It is late, and I will have you on my plate. And now you know bad luck is real. It is my..."
Thank you. I had grown tired from the fight. I swung my hammer with my might. And when I nearly hit her head, she laughed at me, and it broke instead. So I just ran. I ran away. I had no time to stop and pray. And in my path, fixed in a tree, a golden axe was there for me. But as I grabbed and said, "What luck?" I realized my hand was stuck. And then she raised her deadly knife and tried to rob me of my life. But as she swung with evil charm, I moved aside and she chopped my arm. She grabbed it and she said, "How sweet!" And so I got up on my feet. I started running, dripping blood. Well, not a drip, it was a flood. But right behind I heard a crash, and then I fell down with a splash. As I blacked out, I heard a shout, "This one is mine now, you get out!"